Hello everyone, this is Rob, and welcome back to Media Awareness. Oh yeah. I'm here with another first reaction video. Before I get to that, a quick reminder, the fundraiser continues. For those of you unaware, I am a disabled individual, and I use a motorized wheelchair slash scooter all day, every day for my continued independence. With that being said, I need your help. My insurance will not cover anything with regard to my scooter. It's viewed as a quote luxury item, and therefore I'm reaching out to you, my YouTube community. There is a cat falling in the background. Anything's possible here. There is a spot fund account link below in the Wow, flying cats. There is a spot fund account link below in the description in two places. Directly below the title for this in the description, as well as a separate section below that. And any and all help is definitely appreciated. This scooter itself is all I have as far as my everyday mobility. I am really unable to use a standard wheelchair or any other type of scooter for that matter due to my dexterity issues and only having primary use of one hand. So I am quite limited, and unfortunately, this is what I need to keep operational. For that to happen, I need to have parts on hand in the event they fail. That way they can be replaced ASAP. I pride myself on my independence in my life and strive to be the most independent person that I can possibly be. So, as stated, any and all support is welcome, and I do hope that you guys will consider contributing. I do want to extend a gracious thank you to those who have contributed thus far, as your contributions have made an incredible difference in my life. And the same goes for those who plan on contributing, as your contributions will definitely be welcome and be helpful towards obtaining the necessary replacement parts in the event these parts fail and some are showing more wear and tear than I would like. So, thank you in advance. Simply click on the spot fund account link below and contribute what you can, and thank you. So, yeah, this is a first reaction video to Taylor Swift performing the Earth, Wind, and Fire classic September, a song that I never really liked. So let's see if Taylor Swift can make me like this. If by chance this is blocked, you'll find a link for the video itself. I think it's just a standard slideshow of different images, or maybe just one image. I really didn't see much of the video as far as this preview goes, but I haven't heard this either, so I'm curious as to what this sounds like. But as always, with all my reactions, it will be linked below for those of you who want to check out in optimum sound quality as opposed to through my video with my picture in the upper corner of the screen somewhere up there. So yeah, that mainly also for the artists themselves and the YouTube channel that posted it, as the artist, musician bands, whoever creates this music for us, no matter the genre, they deserve all the credit in the world, and that's why I do this. Also, I cover all types of media here, films, literature, art in general, although I haven't covered any art per se. Unless you want to consider some music and literature and films as art, which I do, so I guess that does count. So, without further ado, let us roll Taylor Swift, September, a cover of the Earth, Wind, and Fire classic. And let's see if Taylor can make me like this song.
Do you remember the 28th night of September? Love was changing the minds of pretenders while chasing the clouds away. Our hearts were ringing in the key that our souls were singing as we danced in the night. Remember how the stars stole the night away.
Honestly, really enjoyed that a lot. I never liked the original, as I said, that wasn't originally performed by Earth, Wind, and Fire back in the 70s, I believe. And I never liked the original, but this one was really, really a nice, more mellow take on that. And I do like Taylor's approach using banjo. That's what that instrument is, for those of you unaware, in the intro section that is accompanying her voice. It's a banjo. It's not really used that often in pop music, at least today. And there's only a few cases of banjo I can think of outside of the bluegrass circuit and perhaps some country, and that would be specifically on Porcupine Tree, their song Trains off of In Absentia. There's banjo on that, and I found that to be unusual considering the genre, but this was really a nice take on the song, and I like it a lot. I really like it a lot. Like I said, I'm a big supporter of Taylor Swift. I think she's incredibly talented, amazing singer, songwriter, producer, talented individual, and she's from Pennsylvania, so we have that in common, right, Taylor? Yeah. Like you're watching this video. I'm impressed, though. This was a great, great song, and great performance of the song, and it made me appreciate the song. That and it made me appreciate a song I never thought I would appreciate. So, for whatever that's worth. So yeah, Taylor Swift, September. Check it out. Link below. You'll find this actual video below the description, and below that, you'll find the link for the fundraiser. And please don't forget to try and contribute what you can, and all help is definitely appreciated. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel, become part of my ever-growing YouTube family. I'd love to have you. And don't forget, if you're new here, welcome. And if you're not, well, welcome back. And don't forget that this New Year's Eve, only, oh God, less than 2 days, you'll be able to see the top 10 albums according to Media Awareness for 2023. And I'm really excited to be bringing you the second annual Media Awareness Top 10 albums. So that's exciting for me, and I hope it's equally as exciting for you. You may find things there that you never knew existed, or you may even just revisit some old classics, as far as artists that you may have forgotten existed. So, and in any event, it'll be an array of, a wide array actually, of different artists. And I'll also be doing an honorable mention category for a few artists in particular. I have those set aside, and also I'm going to be highlighting two albums by two separate artists that have really moved up on my list of albums since last year when they were released in 2022. And I'm really pleased to be able to say that these albums have moved up on my ranking since doing last year's countdown. They really have become part of my listening experience on a more day-to-day basis, and I can really appreciate them more than previously. They just needed some time to grow on me, per se, and they grew on me very, very profoundly. So I'm looking forward to sharing that with you as well on New Year's Eve, and the video will be here for you all to see at your convenience. Also, please feel free to peruse my videos. There's a lot here. Once again, as always, this is Rob with Media Awareness. I hope you all have a wonderful morning, noon, or night, wherever you are. Take care. Bye.